Watch 12 brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. The future in trucks is here. The all-new 2014 Chevy Silverado delivers where you need it. Strength, towing, payload, torque, and fuel efficiency. It works as hard as you do. Chevy, the official vehicle of the Green Bay Packers.
Wind chill warning continues until noon on Tuesday. Yeah, it's still dangerous out there. As the day goes on, it gets a little bit better. Winds won't be as strong. Temperatures actually warming back up to zero. And sad to say, zero is an improvement. But in the morning, we'll still have wind chills to 40 to 45 degrees below zero. These are the expected temperatures in the morning. A lot of places going to 20 degrees below zero. Not record territory, surprisingly enough, but certainly the coldest air that we've seen since 1996 around here. Let's take a look at what we're expecting for those wind chills as we head throughout the night tonight and into tomorrow. Again, it is going to be nasty into the morning, but as the day goes on, as the temperatures do start to warm up, the wind chills won't be as bad, but it is still going to be very, very cold all the way throughout the day. The last time it was this cold, Spice Girls were number one, Twister was a hit movie, and gas was only $1.22 a gallon. That was quite a long time ago. Let's take a look at the Doppler 12 radar network. It is quiet around here. The cold air continues to pour in, but this high pressure center, as it moves to the east of us, will actually bring in warmer air, especially as we head into this weekend. High temperature, zero, but that's better than we were throughout the day on Monday. And temperatures will start out cold, and it's still going to be on the chilly side. We get back below zero on Tuesday night into Wednesday morning, but then we go to 12, 25, 35. A little mixture of things coming in here. It should be on the light side, a chance of rain and snow, and then it does warm up into the weekend. For WISN.com, I'm Chief Meteorologist Mark Baden.